Hold Kenya!
Simba, Simba, Simba!
Usawa, haki na ukweli! Ufukile, nobe le mulusumu? Today, for Kenya Party, Bungoma County, the leadership has been meeting our lowest level elected leaders. And our new constitution, our lowest representation and election is at the polling station level. Since we finished our elections, today we made it necessary to meet with our elected managers and chairpersons of polling stations to discuss the issues of the party in the county. We've met here today from 9 a.m. and we have made major milestones for the party in this county. We have emphasized and listened to everybody who wanted to tell us what they want the party to do, and we are very happy that people of Bungoma County, all the communities living in this county, have embraced unity like never before to soldier together for the betterment of the lives of our people. In so doing, we have agreed and resolved that we are going to make very serious party recruitment activities, engineer registration of persons to enable Kenyans without identity cards to get their IDs, and more importantly, to enlist voters on the voters' roll who have not been enlisted so far. Equally important, we have agreed here that the party of Ford Kenya, which is the ruling party in Bungoma and Trans Nzoia, will embark on major consolidation, popularization, and engineering the events in these counties and beyond to make sure that as we support wholeheartedly and in an unqualified manner the PBI process, the party will remain at the center of any form of negotiations for the future of this country. Because we believe, as a party, that the unity of this country, the continuing bringing together of all Kenyans, regardless of their ethnicity, religious affiliation, or race, is the only way to grow. Kenya will only develop when all Kenyans have a sense of pride and belonging to the center of activities of the country. The gathering here today has urged the national government to equitably distribute national resources in terms of development. We have agreed that the leadership of this county is going to continue pressing, encouraging and requesting the national government to bring sufficient resources to revive and revamp Nzoia Sugar Company, which is the only industrial setup that we can talk of in our county. Equally important, we have decided that we will continue engaging the national government to ensure that the highway from Mombasa to Kampala through Bungoma via Eldoret Nakuru is developed into a dual carriageway to reduce the continuing extended vehicles that sometimes have jams from Malaba up to Bungoma. We want to see that when we have a dual carriageway, accidents will reduce, business movement of stocks and persons will be faster, and development will move even faster. We have agreed and resolved that we are going to encourage our county government to partner with the national government to ensure continuing afforestation of Mount Elgon, which is one of the 7 water towers of Kenya, so that those who are dependent on the rivers that come from Mount Elgon downstream all the way up to Lake Victoria enjoy fresh water and continuous supply regardless of the weather. We have agreed here now that as the people of Bungoma, we shall encourage each and everybody through persuasion and any other means necessary to make sure that the party of our forefathers, Masinde Muliro, Wamalwa Kijana, George Captain, and others, remains the party of choice. To this extent, this gathering and these leaders from the grassroots have agreed that they will do everything possible to encourage our brothers and sisters who happen not to be in this party to join the party so that we can all move together as one. We do so appreciating that for us to be able to negotiate for anything meaningful for our region, we must be united and move as a team. Ford Kenya as a party is proud of its history. It's a history where we have produced the vice president of this country in the name of Michael Omalwa Kijana. We are, as a party, looking forward to the day in history when our party will be able to produce a leader beyond the seat of deputy president. We engage meaningfully knowing that with the BBI process, there is going to be constitutional change. All the people of Bungoma and all members of our party have embraced this change. We want to see the country moving to a parliamentary system. We want to see the creation of position of prime minister, deputies, but above all, we want to see a constitution that is going to hold this country together, a constitution that will never, ever again in the history of our country, give and create a situation where one or two communities can lord over others and run away with the country. This has been said in BBI meetings, and we want to know and say as Kenyans that all Kenyans are equal, all Kenyans have equal opportunities, all Kenyans must be respected, and all Kenyans must be able to sit at the table where important decisions of this country are made. These leaders here assembled, and those who are not here, our governor is away in Nairobi in a COG meeting. Dr. Sele, our Secretary General, has just left to run to another meeting. He's here with us. All our MCAs are here. And we have agreed that as I play national politics, the team led by the chairman of the county of the party and all of us here will now more than ever before go to each and every village to market the party and to tell our compatriots in the county that together as one, we shall scale any mountain. Together as one, we shall cross any river. Together as one, we shall swim across any ocean to reach the destination that our forefathers designed for us. Today is a day like no other because the people of grassroots leadership of Bungoma have come together for the first time this year to set the record clear that anybody who thinks that Bungoma is divided has themselves to be put to shame, because Bungoma is united. And united we will come all together, because that is the only way we can grow our county. I want to thank you all for being here today, for staying in the rain, but more importantly, for the most constructive speeches that have been made here. Each one of us, without exception, emphasized respect, emphasized unity, emphasized the need to embrace our party, because the only highway to leadership is through a vehicle called a political party. And I've led this party without wrangles, and continue leading this party as long as you give me the privilege to lead without wrangles. And where there's a divergence of opinion, it is born out of the vibrancy of leadership, not hatred of each other. Because in our house, there's no room for hatred. There's only room for love. There's only room for togetherness. There's only room for forward looking, to make sure that Bungoma, the county, and the only one that in 1959 lent the money to Her Majesty's government in London, goes back to those roots. We want our coffee back. We want our maize back. We want our mink back. We want our sugar back. We want our cotton back. And we want our traders to have money that can percolate into each and every corner of our county, so that when we walk, we're walking among empowered people, people with pride, people with a sense of self-respect, and people who, when they talk, everybody stands to listen. That is the Bungoma we want. That is the Bungoma we must have. Fort Kenya!
Simba, Simba, Simba!
Usawa, haki na ukweli. And for young men from the media, thank you for always being there with us. We walked this journey together. You are our sons and daughters. And our sons and daughters, you shall remain, and we shall treat you with the dignity and the respect you deserve, and urge you to be always ready to report freely, fairly, never exaggerate anything that bring our people to loggerheads. Thank you.
Hey, we just
said it's our time.